There are some misconceptions about logging, but one thing is for certain. We all use wood in our everyday lives, and it's a resource that sometimes gets taken for granted. What most people aren't aware of is that today's loggers are more like gardeners, the stewards of the land.
It's a product, just like your garden. When your garden's ripe, you pick it. When the forest is ripe, you go and thin it, so it can reproduce and do it again.
While there are methods of logging that are beneficial to the land, we are still learning and pioneering new ways of environmentally conscious logging. Where do we go from here? Well, in order to foresee the future of wood procurement, we must first go back in time and retrace its genesis.
1, 2, 3.
Physical force, the most basic way to attack a job like this. While it wasn't easy, it was necessary. And with the lack of technology came innovative thinking. The workers used what they had available to them at the time to get the job done. Crosscut saws were used to cut down trees. Horses with halters and chains were used to get the trees to the landings. Mills were strategically placed so the loggers could utilize the river systems to move the mill-ready logs. These methods worked for many years, and in the late 1800s to early 1900s, cable machinery was introduced into the loggers' workflow. This vastly improved the amount of mill logs they were able to produce. While these methods worked, there was little thought put into what trees were taken. This resulted in too many clear cuts. But even when they weren't clear cutting, there was little regard for which trees stayed and which trees went to the mill. The waste that built up was not so much seen as a resource, but as trash that needed to be disposed of. Burning was the main way of completing this task.
30, 40 years ago, the mills burnt even everything that made it to the mill. If it didn't make a board, it got burned up.
Today, we have much more efficient methods of obtaining and utilizing wood that is not only environmentally sound, but beneficial to the land and the people.
Right up here, I'm going to actually cut these two big fir trees that's right above us. I've got trees I'm going to leave that are behind them. There's some smaller ones and then also some bigger ones that just look healthier. And then this little grove of cedar right here, I'll protect it. I've cut some trees around it already, but they're really nice little grove of cedar that I want to protect.
With technology came new ideas, and with new ideas came new techniques. With the introduction of hydraulics and computer technology, workflow became more efficient and cost-effective, allowing loggers and mill workers to focus more on how they obtained and utilized the wood. Sawdust is compressed into energy logs for homes and businesses. Every part of the log is used, and waste is minimal.
Well, we joke about it, where how can that many loads of logs go in the mill, and then double that, it seems like, loads leave the mill. Everything gets used.
Right. Just like in that log deck right there, the cedar they cut fence boards out of it, the Doug Fir and Larch they cut structural lumber, and then the Ginban logs are the bigger logs that Radicrix buy, and they're cutting lumber out of them and selling them to Japan.
Mulching heads are used to leave behind mulch in logged areas for new plant life to thrive, which in turn enhances the lives of the indigenous wildlife.
Limbs that are left on the trees or left in the woods get mulched back into the ground. Say that's good for the soil, good for the earth. Cutting trees and logging is not a bad thing. It's good for the environment. It's good for the timber ground. That's what people need to understand.
We're beginning to see the makings of a revolution. The next generation of loggers who are not only logging for profit, but to preserve the very landscape they occupy for their families and generations to come. So what does the future hold